Hey, another Die Trying Extra here. I'm Michael Hand. So a lot of people have visited bathroomstatus.com, the website that we set up a few weeks ago to show the status of our office bathrooms. And they noticed that there's a lot of cool charts on the website showing bathroom usage. Now, I didn't show in the episode how I set all that up, so I thought I would show you now all the code that I used and the service that I used to get all these cool charts going. All right, here's the code that I showed off last time. I actually uploaded this to GitHub. I'll put a link in the show notes if you want to take a look yourself. Here's the main thing that I added to the code. It's an add to database function. So I call this every time the bathroom opens back up, and I write the time that the bathroom opened, the count of the previous usage, so how long the person was in there, and then what bathroom it was. I'm just adding that to a MySQL database that I added earlier, and then executing that. So I'm collecting all of this data into a MySQL database. You can see when I actually call it when the bathroom opens up, adding the current time, the count, and what bathroom. So pretty simple. Once I have all this data, then I use a service called Plotly to plot the data. So they have some great API examples using Python and all other different types of code. But so what I do is first I sign in, so you'll get an actual user ID and key from Plotly. Then what I'm doing is I connect to the SQLite database, and basically what I'm doing is based on what I want to do. So on this one, I'm just grouping all of the data into bar charts. So I select everything. I select all the data because I'm not collecting that much from the database where the date is today and the bathroom is bathroom one. From there, I just go through the results of the SQL query, and I'm actually just getting what the value of the time was and then appending that value to an array that I created. I'm doing the same exact thing for bathroom two. And the reason why I'm using Plotly is because things are so easy. So I'm using the histogram function, and all I need to give for this function is the actual time that the person came out of the bathroom. And then this nbin sx is how many groupings Plotly will use to create the bars. So histograms just are collections of data points so that it takes similar ones and groups them together. And then title and kind of just some labels. And then I just give it a file name, and then Plotly does the rest. Very cool to have those Python libraries. You need to make sure that their libraries are imported, but they have info on how to do that. So there's the histogram. I also have cool things like kind of a bubble chart. It's not an exact science, but same sort of thing that I get the hour of when the person comes out. And in this case, I use the count to figure out how big I want the bubble to be. And then I divide by 10 to make the size of the bubbles a little bit more manageable. Then I'm graphing using Plotly scatterplot, and then I'm using that size function to set the bubble size, and then I'm using Plotly to plot, same as last time. So I have even more Python scripts up on GitHub so you can get an idea of exactly what I'm doing with my database manipulation. Check that out and check out Plotly. It's free to sign up, and I definitely recommend it because you can make all sorts of cool graphs. Hopefully that gives you guys some ideas on things you could do with your data. Also check out on Texilla, we had the co-founder Matt Sundquist come on and talk about like even more advanced usage. So check out that episode, subscribe to Die Trying here, new episodes every Monday. See you later.